Hello there, this is Breakman79, and welcome to Let's Play Neverwinter Nights 2. Another great classic Dungeons & Dragons game. I believe this one uses the 3.5 rule set. I've gotten quite used to the AD&D rule set from playing Baldur's Gate 2, so it might take me a little while getting used to this, but yeah, this game is going to be awesome. And I picked the second game because two things. One, I like the party system much, much better than the first Neverwinter Nights game. I never really liked their whole henchman thing. It just feels so much better when you actually have a real party with multiple people, just like in Baldur's Gate. They go running around, kill some dragons, other creatures, you know, good stuff. The other thing is simply the graphics look way better in this game compared to the first one. And I've even added a couple of mods in. I hope it will make it look even better than if I were just playing this vanilla. So anyway, this will be mostly a blind LP. I've played the tutorial a couple of times and maybe about 10 hours into the campaign, but that was way back in like 2008, so I don't remember a whole lot. Anyway, without further ado, let's get cracking. New campaign. We're going to pick the official campaign, because why not? I mean, better start at the beginning. Creating character. This is something I have been thinking about for probably 2 weeks. And there's a website called, if you've ever played this game or you're a fan of it, you probably already know about it. It's called nwn2db.com. It lets you go and look through builds for character classes or create your own. It's very nice and can become quite addicting just playing around with the different options. For this run, we're going to play as a elf. Female, because that's how I roll. I think, let's see here, 2 strength, 2 dexterity. I think we're going to pick a wood elf. She's just going to be slightly shorter than average. That's fine. Let's pick the head here. That one looks pretty good, actually. What are we... No. Let's go with this one. Yeah, it looks fine. Skin color. Looks like we have various shades of brown and green. We can go kind of copper color here. Green, not so much. I think that looks alright. Eye color. Yellow or green. Ooh, that's kind of creepy. Yellow looks alright. Eyebrow. Oh, that's too light. I think that's alright. I think we're gonna go for kind of a... Oh, I didn't change her hair. One of the mods I have is installed as a huge hair selection mod. So let's find one. No. Some of these are pretty outlandish. Very anime-ish. But let's pick something that actually looks like one of the hair models from the vanilla game. No. You can tell easily just the number of... interesting. That looks like French maid hairstyle or something like that. It's actually not too bad. No. Looks like a piece of paper glued on her head. No. I kinda like this one. Okay. Hair color, that's nice. Nice red. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Ooh, we can make it even. I think we're gonna go with this, guys. Looks pretty good. I approve. Ah, the classes. Another thing I thought about a lot. The last time I played this game, and when I played Neverwinter Nights 1, I played as a sorcerer. In Baldur's Gate, we played as a fighter. So I've been thinking, I spent a lot of time thinking, should I be the warlock? Because this is not a role I've ever played. Might be interesting. But I think what I've kind of decided on is going the arcane archer route. So to start with that, is one of the requirements is you need one level in arcane arts. So we're going to start as a wizard just for one round. And then we're going to switch to fighter so that we can unlock the longbow weapon specializations. Alright. Ready. Haha, we're going to be lawfully evil. Because I'm kind of tired of playing good characters. We're going to switch it up. There is a lawfully evil god she can worship. It's like Walthier or something. Yep. Laviatar. There we go. Okay, stats time. Charisma, charisma, constitution. Definitely gonna knock that up. Dexterity is gonna be our highest, or the one that we're gonna pump most into, because all the bow damage is based on that. I think strength of 15. Charisma is another one that we want to keep up a bit. Intelligence is good because that determines how many skills we get each level up. Okay, we got 3 left. I think we're just going to pump it into wisdom here to because we're not really, she's not going to go. Either way, it doesn't really affect it too much because it doesn't raise it the attribute point any. I guess we can just leave it like this. Alright. Background. I think we're going to pick Wild Child for the Tumble, Hide, and Move Silently skills, which we are going to be heavily investing in for our character. Okay, customize the wizard here. Okay, the skills. I actually wrote these down, or more or less I took a picture of how I wanted these to be set, so now I'm looking up in my phone here for what I put for level 1. Okay, move silently. Where are you? We put 2 in there. I put 1 into listen. I think 1 into spot. And 1 into hide. And we're going to put 2 into use magical device. And then we're going to save the rest for the next level up. Okay. Feats. Since we're going to be going across several different classes, we're going to pick Able Learner. So that we don't have to spend 2 points to our skills. Scribe Scroll, Wild Child, Immunity to Sleep, Listen. Someone familiar. Okay. Not a school. Wizard's Desire. I think we're going to pick Evocation here. It doesn't really matter. We're not going to use these spells very much. Suppose we can take Burning Hands. Enlarge Person. Oh, definitely Magic Missile. Shield. I get one more. Maybe... let's see. Plus 20 bonus to attack rolls. Protection. Let's go with the protection from alignment here. And that's probably going to be all of our arcane spells. Familiar. I think we're going to go with the rabbit here. Look at the little cuddly bunny. Just because of his bonus to all saves, which is nice. Familiar name. Phanos. Or Panos. Arcane. Wow. Tojan. Or Toen. Kala. Oh, that sounds alright. First name. Alright. Her name is going to be Aaron. Blue Stone. And she's going to be kind of young for an elf. Let's make her 47 years old. And
attack!
I think that's...
Oh, Sobre! Ready for me, are you? I think not.
It's one thing I didn't really like about this is the, I'm not really fond of any of the female voices. A couple of them are extremely annoying. Like the rogue. Ugh.
To battle! I'll deal with this one!
It just sounds too... I guess I'll just stick with this. And I think we're ready. Here we go, guys. I'm excited!
So many years ago today... Ah, my foster daughter is up and dressed, I see. Today is the High Harvest Fair, and the West Harbor Village Council requires me to man the archery competition. The human need to celebrate Remembrance Days baffles me, but at least something productive may come of it. The merchant Galen is here. He'll want my furs, as he usually does. Coins can be useful in getting by. This past season has been a hard one for both tilled fields and wildlands. While I attend to the archery contest, I will need you to deal with the merchant. Fetch my furs from the chest. Over by the painting.
Ah, you got it, Dad. I don't think I'm going to bother to read these things. We'll just continue along. I know how to get things out of boxes. That is... Wait, where is this thing? Oh, there it is. Wait, is that going to skip the entire tutorial or just... Oh, whatever. Alright, picked up our furs. Let's get it.
Good. I see you have the furs. Galen has probably set up his tent on the village green. He'll be enjoying the fair with the rest of the townsfolk. Last season, I asked him to bring a duskwood bow to trade. Sell him the furs and use the coins it gives you to purchase the bow. Your friends await you at the bridge. I suppose you're anxious to see the fair. But don't forget to trade with Galen.
Okay, got our first quest. So let's head out of here. Okay. We should be able to get through the tutorial in this first episode, no problem. Ah. Yeah, I know how to use the controls. Da-da-da-da. Okay.
There you are! Come on, the fair's already started!
It's the biggest fair in years. There's folk in from all the outlying farms, and even a few from outside the mare. That means a big audience.
A big audience, all cheering for us. This year's our last chance to compete for the Harvest Cup. Our last chance to win!
Yeah, I would have won it last year if I hadn't been saddled with you two.
Don't say that. You two are the only family I've got. Apart from Tarmus, anyway, and he hardly counts.
Besides, we're a team. I know this town hasn't seen anybody as talented as you since Cormac left, but you can't do everything yourself.
I suppose I have no choice. I'll let you tag along again.
Look, just forget it. Let's go sign up with Georg. He's waiting in the village square.
Hmm. Yay, our team members. Companions. Yeah. Whoop. Okay. Let's go talk to...
And the blight. You're sure it's spreading, Orlin?
It's no blight, Georg. It's something else. There's no mold, no rot. It's like the crops don't want to grow. Like they're having the guts to up and face the sun.
What do the druids say?
Well, it's just a rub, Georg. There's no druids to be found, not head nor heel. It used to be they'd warn me of troubles, long before I noticed the signs myself. But this time, we're out in silence. You think we ought to say something? Everyone's gathered for the fair, even from the outlying farms.
No. They ought to be free from cares, at least for a day. We'll go round tomorrow. Talk to the households one by one.
Right you are, Georg. Tomorrow, then.
Aha! You're here after all! I wasn't sure you'd show. Thought you might be out wandering the mare again and miss the fair altogether.
Wouldn't be the first time, if I recall.
It's your last year to compete, isn't that right?
Only for Bevel and me.
Better make it count, then. Another victory speech from that muttonhead of a Mossfeld, and I think there'll be a riot.
Rules are the same as ever. Win three of the four events, and you win the Harvest Cup. Win all four, and the village council grants you a special prize. And nobody's done that since old Cormac.
Cormac. I remember him vaguely.
Oh, that boy was a legend. Oh, I'm sure there's 100 Cormacs in a city like Neverwinter. But for this town, he was as big as folks get.
Old Cormac fought Lawnstarling in the brawl. And some story that was. But I don't suppose you have time for stories just now.
What are this year's events?
Well, there's the Harvest Brawl. Old favorite, that one. And the Tourney of Talent. But you've got Amy on your team, so you're certain to win.
Thanks, Georg.
Just the truth, young lady. Your foster father's running the archery competition, as always, and I managed to convince Tarmus to supervise the Knave's Challenge. I guess the Knave's Challenge will be your toughest event, though the Mossfeld boys might say otherwise.
And why should they say that? Or... as if I care what the Mossfields say.
Well, Will and his brothers have won the Harvest Brawl 3 years running. It'll be tough to dislodge them.
But remember, you only have to win three events to claim the cup.
Yeah, not a problem. I'll win four. Will Mossfeld is in for serious disappointment.
Keep
keep an eye on Bevel, and don't let the Mossfells get him riled. That's how they always beat him on the practice field.
Yeesh, Georg, I'm right here, you know.
If you have any troubles, you know where to find me. Oh, and good luck in the brawl!
All right, Knave's challenge. Okay, I think first things first, we're going to go the archery challenge. It's definitely the simplest one. Oh, no. Okay, Galen. He's down here somewhere. There he is. Why, you're Dagon's ward, isn't that right? It's been some time, but he didn't happen to mention a shipment of furs, did he? He did, in fact. I have them right here. Ah, good. Dagon's a reliable sort. Always has the highest quality furs. You can't imagine the demand in Neverwinter, relatively speaking. I haven't forgotten his Duskwood bow, either. I always come through. You tell Dagon that. I'll warn you, the bow's a bit pricey, but it's fine workmanship. Sneaked it across the Luskan border. You bought the bow in Luskan? No. From a village called Ember. They're good folk. Just ended up on the wrong side when the maps got drawn. Fine boyers, too. Okay, I'm ready to trade. Okay, store tutorial, don't need it. Oh, disable the pop-ups. Well, maybe I'll keep them active, just in case. Okay, let's sell the fur. Yeah. And buy the bow. No, I can't equip it. Right, because I'm just holding it. Okay. Dagon should be over here.
So, you've decided to compete for the cup, I see. I know this is your last year, but the rules apply to all. Even foster daughters.
I brought the Duskwood bow for you.
A fine bow. A fine one. Made by one who loves his craft. You may keep the rest of the gold as your allowance for the season. But you came for the archery competition as well, did you not?
Yes. I'm ready to compete.
Fetch a crossbow from the barrel and take a few shots at the practice target. You must hit the target once before you can compete.
Okay. Okay, tell us how to equip them. Okay. Equipped. Alright. We know how to shoot.
Are you ready to compete, then?
Yep.
The rules are the same as last year. 10 shots and 10 targets. Your targets will be old bottles, set atop the crates yonder. 5 is the best score so far. If you remember the lessons that have been taught to you, you should be able to best that.
Yeah, no problem. Come on. Okay. Say goodbye, bottles. That's one down.
So brave, so dead.
Okay.
Ready for me, are you? I think not.
Mm-hmm. Easy peasy.
So brave, so dead. So brave, so dead.
3 rounds left. Not an issue. Very good.
Well done. I think your score will stand this year, but I will remain here until day's end, awaiting those who wish to shoot for fun. Go on now. There's still more of the fair to see.
Okay, time for the Neve's challenge.
Enjoying the fair, packs of feral children set loose to find trinkets. Grown men braining one another with clubs. Do you know they're actually granting prizes for the fattest pig? As if the creatures needed encouragement.
Quit your grumbling, wizard.
Who's grumbling? They've given me charge of the knave's challenge. I always tell them we ought to encourage thievery in our children. Good for the mind. We live in a swamp, after all. What else is there to do? Come to think of it, I don't believe any of you has the skills to compete. Not that I'm complaining, mind you. But you'll need to find someone who can pick pockets and break locks and search for hidden trinkets if you want to compete.
Lockbreakers? Pocket pickers? I don't know anyone like that. Do you?
One of these children.
What about Kip? He's always nicking vials from Tarmas, and he's right over there behind the tent.
Exactly. Look, I'm just watching the fair, alright? Whatever it is, I ain't done it. Actually, we were wondering if you'd like to join our team. Well, really? You mean compete for the cup? But I'm just a kid. I mean, I'm old enough to be on a team and all. Yeah, really. We want you on our team. Hey, brilliant. Sorry for beating that big lummox on the head all those times. Didn't mean any harm by it. He's just funny when he gets angry. That was you? Every day during drills I get hit by acorns. And it was this kid? I can't believe nobody told me. Georg had me thinking it was pixies. Ha, I like this kid already. Well, I've got my eye on him. Next time I get hit with an acorn, a certain pixie is going to have a broken wing. Alright.
Isn't that the boy who stole my basilisk eyelash? And not once, but four times.
That's right. My frog needed eyelashes. Then I got him a sweetheart and she needed him too.
Sorry, Thomas. He's just joined our team.
Don't trouble yourself on my account. I'll settle with the young artiste and his frogs later. Before you begin, I suppose you'll want to hear the rhyme.
Not really.
All the more unfortunate for me, then. It's always better to have a willing audience, especially when one's material is particularly dreadful. But Georg asked for a rhyme. That's what wizards do, after all. We compose rhymes. Here, I'll demonstrate. I've hidden three feathers, scattered them wide, placed white in a box, and locked it inside. Blue followed termite tracks down where they ran, green in the pocket of same-colored man.
That's the stupidest rhyme I've ever heard, Tarmas.
Count yourself fortunate for that. I once shared a wagon with a kobold bard. He rhymed sadder with bladder and sang fondly of his navel. As dreadful as it was, did you understand what the rhyme meant?
Of course.
Yes, you have the right of it. Three feathers, white, blue, and green.
This shouldn't be difficult. Alright. And this really isn't very difficult, although Kip might have some trouble. I seem to recall, like, when you're low level. Okay. Look, there's something under them logs. Get up here, kid. Whoa. Ah. That old wizard's trapped them logs. We can't get what's underneath them long as the trap's in place. I've got past his traps before, though, and they was the dangerous kind. Betcha I can get past this one, too. Yeah, telling you how to get past. Wait, in detect mode. Right. Okie dokie. Let's see if he can disarm it. Nice. Got the feather. Okay, next we're gonna break into this chest up here. Mm-hmm. Let's see if he can unlock it. Sweet. Okay, and the last part was we have to pocket the guy in the green shirt over here. Like I said,
in the pocket of same colored man. I'll bet that's him over by the house. The feather's in his pocket. It's got to be.
Yeah, as I was about to say, I've played the tutorial about a half a dozen times, so I remember it very well. Let's see. All right. Oh, wrong character. There we go. And that's that.
Follow me. Closely.
Now we just head back and deliver the feathers.
It really is a dreadful day for a fair. Not even the tents are managing to look cheerful.
You didn't hide those feathers very well. We found them all.
Thank the gods. The knave's challenge is won, and I can go someplace dry. I'd kiss all of you, but no one respects an affectionate wizard.
Best of luck getting dry. This is a swamp, after all.
No need to remind me. I try never to leave my home, unless I'm looking for a bath.
And we've earned our first level up. Okay. So. No. Uh-oh. What was the skills? Strategy mode, no. It's not inventory. Character. There we go. Level up. Where are you? There you go. Okay, now we comes the good stuff. We switch from being a wizard to a fighter. And the skills that we need, let's see. Crack out my phone again. Level 2, we are going to put 2 into Tumble, if I can find it. Two into Diplomacy. And the final 2 is going to go into Hide. Alright, so I should just say the final 1, right? That one will carry over. Ah, the feats. Okay. Different picture. We're going to choose point blank shot. Because like I said, archery is our thing. Required for rapid shot. Negates the -4 penalty for using melee missile weapons in melee. Additional 1 to attack. Sounds good. Got 9 hit points. Armor proficiencies. Okay. Now we need to level up our friends here. Let's see, what is he? He is a lawfully good fighter. Change anything there. Probably choosing recommended is fine. Was that all he had? Okay, so he's putting it into taunt and parry. Yeah, okay, whatever. General feats, what is it going to recommend? Knockdown. We could go with, well, I guess it's not. Okay, next. She is a wizard. Right, it's probably gonna up her concentration. Craft alchemy. Why would you pick that? Spellcraft is good. I guess it doesn't really matter. Whatever. She's got enlarged person. Identify. Now, I seem to recall there's something that we can do, because there's that, like, giant pig. But I don't remember. I'm gonna cancel this for now. We can level up him, he's a rogue. Sure. Okay. Who do I need to talk to about it? Some big pig, eh? Get your harvest mead, cold harvest mead. Mug of mead and be quick about it. What? Oh no. Not you lot. Got that fern goal with you too. I haven't forgotten what happened last year, lung lady. Even if you have. Maybe we better go. Aye, the business of the roof. With the swinging hips and that vulgar song. Not this year, young lady. On your way now. All of you. Swinging hips? Haha, she's blushing. Look at her cheeks go red. You told me you made that up. Give us a song, then. No thanks. Not without a whole lot of mead. I don't even think I knew any body songs. Who was it I needed to talk about? The pigs. Ah, maybe this guy, Brother Marion. Oh no. Oh no, he's... No, we'll be back later for that. What about Orlin here? Oh. He wants to see the act? I suppose we can do that. Quick, quick! They're all waiting for you, dear. Waiting for me? Of course! Juggling and puppetry are well and good, but the children want to see magic, and so do I. Come on, Amy. Your public awaits. Okay. Here you'll learn the basics of spell casting. Set as a primary character. Let's press F. Okay. All of her memorized spells. Okay. Miscasting your spells, click the rest. I suppose I'm supposed to... Can I enlarge the cat? Or am I supposed
follow
to...
me closely.
Oh. Maybe I should just rest a moment. Alright, let's try this again. I thought I had a summon spell. She says a summoning spell would be an awfully nice start. Oh, okay, there we go. Who did I have selected? Oh, no wonder. Cast an enlarged person spell on Bevel. Okay. To complete her act, Amy will cast an offensive spell at a destroyable target. Target the old barrel. Ray of Frost or Acid. Let's go with the Ray of Frost. Excellent! Amy's magic has won over the crowd. Talk to Retta Starling, she has a prize for you. Now that you've tried the basic spell cast and you explore your spellbook, player manual, press B. Okay. That was brilliant, young lady! Absolutely brilliant! I've not seen such a display of magic since... well... Mother, you all right? It's been a long time. Never mind all that. You three are almost certainly the winners of the contest. That was quite a thrill for all of us. Oh, and I nearly forgot. Tarmis gave me these scrolls, said I should give them to his apprentice and her friends if they won the talent show. Say, that was quite a show. You're good with the magic, young Amy, more than passing skillful, if you ask me. Though, I know you didn't. I wonder if you might have a look at a pig. Uh-huh. As I was talking, the pig! Aye, that great hulking brute of Lily Jones, his prize pig, he calls it. But I call it a trick, a cheat. I've never seen that hog before, and I have an eye for hogs, as folk will tell you. I say he's been magicked. Ensorcelled. Ensorcelled? But I can't prove it myself. Hmm. Alright, we'll take a look at this pig. I much appreciate that. He's the big one down on the end. If you'll find any magic on him, come back and tell me straight away. Alright, we got a bonus quest.
Well, Orland's right. This pig's been enchanted. It's a faint aura, so it could have been a simple enlargement spell, or maybe a potion.
Can you dispel it?
Well, Retta did give us a scroll of lesser dispel. All I'd have to do is read the words.
Wait a minute. Shouldn't we say something to Louis? He's a foul old wretch. But we ought to give him a chance to withdraw his pig from the contest before he's shamed in front of everyone.
Nah, I don't think so. That's his own fault. We're gonna use a scroll. To remove the enchantment of Louis' Hog, you will need to use your Scroll of Lesser Dispel. Single use stored. Oh, we definitely have to use a magic device. Okay. Lesser Dispel. Let's see. There we go. Hell's take you! Look what you've done to my pig! Did you see the expression on that hog's face? Had a few glorious hours of being a big porker, lording it over his seniors, but now he's back to his poor little self. I bet there'll be some uncomfortable moments in the pigsty tonight. And I'd say that the last time any of you tries the magic hog in this contest, hate to see old Louis shamed, but he brought it on himself. That fat braggart deserved what he got. Well, I might not have put it that way, but I suppose you're right. And did feel a bit bad. Oh no, always did feel a bit bad for Louis' animals living on that slovenly style of a farm. Have some of this. It's pork jerky. Tough, dry meat. But it tastes like heavens and keeps longer than bad memories. Good food for the road if you ever plan on taking a long walk. Pork jerky. Next time I won't even bother. Alright. We can level her up now. Let's see. Blades of Fire. Subject melee weapons up to 2 wielded weapons can deal an extra 1d8 points of fire damage. Let's take that. I wonder what the recommended was. Oh, and summon creature 1. Sure. Okay. Is there like a quick save to this game? Sure. Tutorial. Alright, I think we are ready for the battle.
Yes.
Huh. Oh. Wasn't there... Web moss filled. I thought... I have this, like, vague memory that you can have, like, a bet with them or something. Well... The Morning Lord grants a fine day, even for a brawl. He likes you, Harborman, I think. Brother Mary, you are running the Harvest Brawl? In truth, I volunteered. Otherwise, I'd be racing from the church at every bout, mending cuts and setting bones to the right. Better that I'm on hand to do Lathander's work and to see all is fought in fairness. A pity West Harbor doesn't love Lathander better. That is a truth that I've labored to change, but I fear that the Morning Lord and I are seen equally as strangers. Perhaps it is as my brother said. Try to bring light to a swamp, Marion, and your torch may gutter out. We're ready to fight. Practice a bit first. There are practice dummies just over there. Once you've finished off a dummy, I'll send you into the ring. And you'll need to arm yourself with a training club. I've left several clubs in the barrel here next to me. Okay. Equip a melee weapon as you would arrange, only don't worry about ammo. Okay. So I've still got a crossbow. Sword icon. Ghostly visage. Okay, so I'm gonna have that. He's gonna have one. She's gonna be doing her magic thing. Alright. Let's go beat up some dummies.
Oh, I think this one wants to play.
Hey. Okay. I think that's probably good. The Lannan twins and their elder sister will be your first opponents today. Before we start, I'll go over the rules. Sure. As always, I expect a clean fight. Melee attacks only. No arrows or magic. You may fight barehanded, or you may arm yourself with a training club. The choice is yours. And finally, no bets. What? No bets? The Harvest Fair is an act of worship, Aaron. A prayer of thanks to Chontia, and to all the gods. The events must be fair and just. Spectators are allowed to bet, it's true, but never competitors. That would tempt unfair arrangements. You can see that, I'm sure. Not all the gods object to a good bet. What of smiling Taimora? I suppose that's true. Lady Luck could hardly object to a bet. But even she would want that bet to be fair. And if the fighters themselves are betting, how can we be sure that the one hasn't made a secret arrangement with the other? No. If you wish to compete, you must follow the rules. I'm sorry. Very well. No bets. Lathander's strength be with you then. Okay, your first battle is about to begin. Oh no, he's out there. Thought he was gonna partake. Oh!
Ah, come on.
Hold on a minute here. Our little... Oh, wrong guy.
What's up?
I...
What's up?
Huh.
Follow me. Closely.
Okay. That was well fought, all three of you. But I fear the gods have granted you a few competitors this year. The Mossfield brothers are the only team still in contention. Give us some time to rest first. Yes, better that you face the Mossfields fresh. They have had ample time to recover their last match, after all. As soon as you feel you've recovered, go tell the Mossfields that you're ready to begin. They await you at the edge of the ring. Okay.
Yep.
Kip. Switch that out.
Yes, indeed.
Switch that.
Oh, yes.
Okay, I think we are good to go. Look who it is, brothers. Everyone's favorite for the brawl, looking to beat the champ of 3 years running. Think she's Cormac, this one. Stow it, Mossfield. You're not smart enough to be funny. Who asked you, you ratty little orphan? Always tagging after Starling and Bluestone like a blood fly, singing their reeking praises. It's a shame those demons didn't burn you up along with your parents. Are you ready to fight or not? Yeah, we're ready. But why not stir the pot some? Raise the stakes. Make me a friendly wager. Sorry, Mossfield, I don't trust you to pay up. Come on, brothers, we'll fight these cowards anyway. Okay. Okay, no. If I remember correctly, you can't attack with magic, but you can use it defensively. which is exactly what we're going to be doing here. Okay. Bevel. Okay. Can I cast this on myself? Oh, okay. Yeah, now we're talking.
Bust him up. Get him.
Oh. Well, I died. Doesn't matter. Well done, all three of you. The townsfolk compare you to Cormac, and it seems they aren't mistaken. I haven't seen such prowess in years. You've won the brawl, and you've won the cup as well. Georg will want to see you at once. Thank the gods, Aaron, for truly they have shown you favor today. Woohoo! Ooh. Let's do a little bit of rest in here. There we go. Okie doke, Georg. Where are you?
Well played. Well played. You've won the cup. And all four events. Nobody's done that since Cormac. That warrants a special reward, of course. I have a harvest cloak for you,
woo-hoo,
courtesy of the village council. It'll be yours at the end of the day. If there's anything you wanted to do before the award ceremony, now's the time. Maybe a mug of harvest mead to celebrate, eh?
Or maybe some well-deserved bragging. What's the point of winning if you don't get a chance to gloat?
I'll meet you at the stage when you're ready for the victory speech. Now, I'm off.
Ooh, level ups. Okay. I think it's gonna be just be more fighter classes here. Da-da-da-da-da, let me check. Yes. Level 3. What do I have here? We got move silently. We got tumble. We've got diplomacy. We've got hide, and we've got use magic device. All right. Okay, feats. For this, we're going to choose power attack. Okay. And cleave for our second one here. Okay. Let's see. Character with a feat can make more powerful but ungainly attacks. +3 bonus to damage roll, but at the cost of -3 to attack roll. Cleave. Character kills an opponent and he gets a free attack against any opponent who's within melee weapon range, which is very good for a fighter. Hit points, 9 again, yes. Alright, let's level up our other people. Recommends, fine. Great fortitude. He is going to take power attack. Level up. Amy. recommend. For a wizard, combat casting. Definitely combat casting. Actually, I'm curious, what would it recommend? Defense? Why would you do that? Let's just take combat casting. Huh. Invisibility? Is this only happen on the... it's not very useful. Well, I mean, for scouting. Not for combat, though. Web. Ugh. Fire. Target burst. Only 8 points of damage. Protection from arrows. Summon creature 2. Switch that out for let's choose melts acid. Oh, I could go with let's take the acid arrow. And last but not least, recommend weapon focus short sword. I guess that's all right, whatever. There's one thing I need to double check. That is to make sure that I have the right... texture quality. I could bump up the... Okay, yes, I do have it set to the hardcore rules here. Okay. Whoop. Where am I?
Oh, yes.
Okay, let's head for the stage, which I believe is all the way down here at the end.
Best I keep quiet, lest anyone think me sociable.
Oh, here we go.
Gather round, mates! Gather round! This harvest fair's a celebration, but it's also a dark anniversary. We all know what else happened on this day. Not so long ago, we nearly lost this village. Almost lost our lives. Almost lost it all. But we came back. Cleared burnt farms, buried our dead, and put our ashes behind us. And we rebuilt, tougher and stronger than ever. Long as there's a harvest fair, we won't forget that day. And our young folks, they'll stay tough, long as they compete for the Harvest Cup. So let's hear it for this year's winners. 3 cheers for the Harvest Champions! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
Huzzah!
Hip hip hooray!
I think they seem a little happier. They don't seem very happy at all. Okay. And that's the end of the tutorial. Start of chapter 1.
The village is under attack! West Harbor is under attack! You're safe! Grab a weapon. We need to help defend the village.
Okay, well, I need to go. What's going on?
I'm not sure! They came pouring in from the swamp and started tearing the village apart!
We better hurry. I saw some of them following us on our way here. They're likely to hit this house next.
Where's my equipment?
It's in that chest next to your bed. You keep everything in there, remember? Hurry up and arm yourself. The longer we wait, the more we put the village at risk.
Okay, guys. I do have that nice little cloak there. Weapons next to the bed. Door. Wait a minute, I don't see anything.
Are you sure you want to be going in there? Your father isn't the most understanding person I've ever met.
Why did you tell me to go pick up myself from the chest and then complain about going into my father's room? Exotic weaponry. Averine's Amulet of Aid. Huh, this guide. Oh, it's basically a book. Okay. Why can't I use this? This item is a 3-inch diameter gold disc with the holy symbol of Averine inlaid in platinum. Grants the wearer the ability to cast aid 6 times. Cannot be used by an evil creature. Oh, well, that's why. Is that the only chest in here? Well, anyway, I think this is going to be the end of this episode, guys. We've started chapter 1, so now comes the fun part. Combat. Real combat. So thanks for watching, guys. In the next episode, we're going to go out there and kick some butt. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.